Good afternoon. Today I'm going to be reviewing the Octopus Kraken. This watch is available from Octopus Kraken Ali Store on AliExpress. During the 11/11 sale, the price of this watch will be €291. So firstly, let's look at the box that the watch comes in, and then I'll talk you through the other items one gets with the piece. So the Octopus Kraken comes in a black plastic Pelican style case. I'll show you the interior. As usual, it has two foam panels which protect the watch and shipping from any damage. Now I want to give due credit to Octopus Kraken because this is a better quality Pelican style case than I've seen other watch brands use. It has heavier plastic clips which are going to be more durable, and they deserve full credit for not cutting any corners with regards to the quality of the Pelican style case they are using. With regards to the other items, this is the owner's instruction manual. Clear, concise diagrams and the instructions are in English. It details the operation of the movement used, which is the Calibre PT5000. This is the plastic guarantee card, and as you can see, the date of purchase, and also it's stamped by Kraken Watches, so it's fully filled in. And I'm pleased to report that the Octopus Kraken is covered by a 12-month international guarantee, which is very reassuring. And lastly, one also gets this Octopus Kraken branded microfiber polishing cloth. I always think it's a nice touch to get a branded microfiber polishing cloth, irrespective of the price point of a piece. So, with regards to the specifications of the piece, this is the Octopus Kraken. As you can see, it is clearly an homage to the Omega Seamaster Professional. Very similar case proportions to the Seamaster, 42.6mm case diameter. It has a lug-to-lug measurement of 49.6 millimeters. It has a thickness of 14 millimeters, and it has a lug width of 20 millimeters. The seatbelt weave nylon NATO strap is 20 millimeters parallel. It doesn't taper. It's 20 millimeters at the lugs, down to the buckle and tang. Solid stainless steel buckle and tang, signed to high standard with Octopus Kraken, as one would expect. Brushed satin finish to the buckle and tang, and also on the keepers and the hardware throughout. Good quality seatbelt weave fabric to the NATO strap, and I like the fact the ends of the NATO strap, the edges are stitched with a contrasting charcoal grey fabric. Plenty of holes in the strap, as you can see, for fine tuning the length, and I like the heavy gauge of the seatbelt weave NATO. It feels like ballistic NATO nylon, so it's very good quality fabric and it's not going to split or crack with regular use. I also like the fact they've welded the end of the strap, so it's not going to fray with regular use. The two keepers either side are fully stitched, so they're not going to slip out of position, and it's also, as you can see, a double pass NATO, so it fits around the spring bars very well. Very good quality. So with regards to the rest of the specification, double dome sapphire crystal, and it has clear anti-reflective coating on the underside, which does an excellent job of reducing the glare and the highly reflective nature of the silver applied indices and the silver arrow hands, as you can see. I like the attention to detail. If you look closely at the counterweight on the sweeping second hand, you can see how they have integrated the Octopus Kraken brand emblem, and it's very nice attention to detail. They have also added two loom dots, one at the front end, one at the counterweight end, so it actually has two loom dots on the second hand rather than the conventional one. Also nice attention to detail, the tip of the sweeping second hand is orange tipped, which matches the, sorry, it's red actually, which matches the red text on the dial. Very nice attention to detail. I like the fact the dial isn't over branded with text and specification. It simply says Octopus Kraken at 12 o'clock, and at the 6 o'clock position it says automatic with a water resistance rating 300 meters/1000 feet. So let's test the crown action. Solid stainless steel crown made from 316L grade, coin edge finish to it, flawless mirror polishing to the cap, and it is embossed with the Octopus Kraken brand emblem. So let's test the action. Absolutely silky smooth. Minimal resistance required, and the PT5000 has a characteristic pop which pushes the crown out of the movement. So in the first position, it's the manual wind position, and one can feel the tension gradually building up in the mainspring to top it up to its maximum 40 hours. So absolute pleasure to manually wind. Now the PT5000 is a date complication movement, so in the first click position it does have a phantom date wheel position, and the date wheel still exists, it's underneath the dial, but of course because there is no date window one cannot see it, but one can feel the click of the date wheel moving around. Pulling it out to the second click is the time setting position, and if you look closely at the second hand, you can see I have now hacked the second hand and stopped the movement dead. So this is the time setting position. Absolutely silky smooth, both clockwise and anti-clockwise. It's a characteristic of the PT5000, which is a clone of the ETA 2824-2. Very light resistance to the gearing. It feels like there's no friction whatsoever. So it's an absolute pleasure to set the time. Pushing it back in, it's got a nice positive click, which restarts the movement. So I'll test screwing it back down. Immediate thread pickup. This is an excellent, very well executed screw down crown, which provides an effective hermetic seal to 300 meters of water resistance. Immediate thread pickup between the internal thread of the solid stainless steel crown and the external thread of the stainless steel crown tube. Octopus Kraken deserve full credit for making a very well executed crown. I would describe this as equal quality to the Amiga Seamaster crown. I previously reviewed an Amiga Seamaster and the crown felt exactly the same, so they are producing very high quality crown actions. The bezel is 120 click unidirectional bezel, as one would expect, so let's test the bezel action. Very smooth. Nice even resistance all the way through the 360 degrees of rotation. It's got a lighter bezel action than a Steinhardt Ocean 139. It feels very similar to Seiko bezel actions, such as the SKX007 and the Seiko Turtle, for example, if you're familiar with those. So I like the lighter bezel action. No lateral side-to-side play whatsoever. No back play whatsoever. This is the perfect bezel action. So let's just check the alignment. Perfect. The loomed triangle on the ceramic bezel insert aligns perfectly with the double indices at 12 o'clock. So no lateral side-to-side play, no back play, perfect alignment. But it has light resistance, so this really is an example to other watch brands of how to get it correct. Octopus Kraken deserve full credit for an outstanding bezel action and outstanding crown action at this price point. So, at 10 o'clock we have a helium escape valve as per the Seamaster, which this is an homage to, and as you can see, we have the HE symbol in the periodic table for the element helium. So let's unscrew it and test the action. Absolutely silky smooth. It feels exactly the same as the crown. Perfect thread action. If you look closely at the base, one can see there is a red rubber O-ring, which provides an effective hermetic seal to 300 meters, as does the crown. I'll test screwing it back down. So I just want to clarify, this is a fully operational helium escape valve. It's not a replica. It actually does work. It has a valve inside. Perfect. It's got a very silky smooth thread action to the helium escape valve, and it's finished to perfection with HE on it, mirror polish cap and coin edge finishing to it. So it's beautiful. Now, with regards to the case finishing, it's one of my favourite aspects of the piece. Longitudinal brush satin finishing to the flanks, which is done to a very high standard. This is the kind of case finishing one would expect to see on a high tier piece. When I'm referring to high tier, I'm talking about watches in excess of 5,000 euro. To get this kind of brush satin finishing, beautiful luster to it, at 291 euro, it is just exceptional. Large chamfers machined to the top edges of the lugs as per the Seamaster, which this is an homage to. Flawless mirror polishing to the chamfers on all four of the lugs. Absolutely beautiful to look at. So the mirror polishing to the chamfers contrasts beautifully with a brush satin finishing to the flanks, which has a lovely luster to it. The crown guards are also mirror polished to a flawless standard, as you can see. So really, this is very similar quality case polishing to an Amiga Seamaster, which is incredible, bearing in mind that this is only 291 euro. Right, so I'll give you a wrist shot and you can see how it fits on my 8-inch wrist. Now, often I'm critical of watch brands because their straps do not fit my large 8-inch wrist. However, I'm pleased to report that this seatbelt weave nylon NATO strap fits my 8-inch wrist to perfection, as if it was bespoke, made to measure. As you can see, look, I can engage the end of the strap in both of the keepers. So this will fit you if you have a large wrist up to 8 inches, as I do myself, as you can see. Fits my wrist to perfection. Now, things to note. It's a large 42.6mm case diameter, so if you're a collector with a smaller wrist of 6 to 7 inches, you may find that this wears with too much wrist presence and heft to be comfortable to wear for long periods of time, such as 8 to 12 hours per day. However, if you are a collector with a larger wrist of 7 to 8 inches, you are going to enjoy the 42mm wrist presence. Although it's a large piece, it is lightweight. It lacks heft. It's only 98 grams on the NATO strap. This is one of the most comfortable watches I have ever worn on a NATO strap. I've experimented with wearing this for 8 to 12 hours per day, and I can tell you it feels incredibly well balanced. It doesn't feel top heavy, and it just feels very comfortable to wear. The feel good factor and the comfort level are outstanding. The thing to note is it is a rather tall piece at 14mm due to the double dome sapphire crystal, as you can see. Now, with a double pass NATO strap, that does add some thickness to the overall thickness of the watch on wrist. So if you wear business shirts, if you're going to be wearing this as a daily wear piece, it's going to be slightly more difficult to slip it underneath a shirt cuff. Really, 13mm is the sweet spot to easily be able to slip a dive piece underneath a shirt cuff. So you may need to consider wearing this on a leather strap, rubber strap, or alternatively a single pass NATO or Zulu strap, because a single pass NATO is lower profile than a double pass, as you can see, and therefore that will bring it down by a millimeter and make it feel more like a 13mm piece, even though the head of the piece, including the double dome sapphire crystal, is actually 14mm. Very comfortable, and the lack of heft at 98 grams means it feels weightless on wrist. So I really like the feel good factor of it, and I like the comfort level. Now I want to show you the case back, so I'm just going to remove the NATO strap. The case back is beautifully engraved with the specification and also the Octopus Kraken brand emblem. So I want to show that to you because it's one of my favorite aspects. As you can see, absolutely gorgeous engraving to it. Just beautiful attention to detail. Longitudinal brush satin finishing to the center section of the screw down case back. The case back is made from solid 316L grade stainless steel. The circumference is engraved to high standard with the specification of the piece, and it has the similar toothed profile to it as per the Omega Seamaster, which this is an homage to. So Octopus Kraken deserve full credit for a very well executed engraving on the case back. It's absolutely gorgeous to look at the brand emblem and very nice detail to it. No sharp edges, no burrs to the engraving, and that's something I was critical of the Steinhardt Ocean 139. The engraving on the Steinhardt Ocean 139 is actually so sharp, it sometimes has burrs or sharp edges to the engraving, which can feel irritant to the wrist. But with this, the engraving is actually beautifully smooth. There's no sharp edges or burrs. So if you wear this on a rubber strap or a leather strap, for example, exposing the case back, it's not going to irritate the wrist. So absolute gorgeous detail to it. I really like the quality of the engraving. Right, so I'm just going to put the NATO strap back on. Now, thing to note is there's quite a tight fit between the head of the piece and the spring bar, but one can easily get the NATO strap through. Now, this is a very thick NATO strap. It's seatbelt weave, but it's like ballistic NATO material. So just bear with me. Right, so let's do a loom test and we'll see how the loom performs when it's charged up to its absolute maximum. So as always, I'm going to use my 100 UV LED torch to charge it up to its absolute peak. Right, so that's now fully charged, and as you can see, it has not disappointed. This is top grade BGW9 Super Luminova. It is 10 out of 10. In particular, Octopus Kraken deserve full credit for the fully loomed ceramic bezel insert. I actually regard this to be superior to the ceramic bezel insert used by Omega themselves on the Seamaster, because that has a circular loom pip to the ceramic bezel insert. This has a large loomed triangle, and as you can see, the large BGW9 loomed triangle performs better. I like the fully loomed minute ticks in the first quarter of the ceramic bezel insert and the large fully loomed Arabic numerals, clearly legible. The loom on the dial, hands and the ceramic bezel inserts are glowing brightly, and they're continuing to glow for a good length of time. Now, another thing I prefer about this Octopus Kraken to the Seamaster is if you look at the hands, they are arrow hands, but they aren't skeletonized as per the Seamaster. They are fully loomed with several layers of BGW line, and therefore they are performing very well. The lack of a date complication at 6 o'clock means the dial has perfect symmetry. The 963 indices are perfectly symmetrical, and the use of the double applied indices at 12 o'clock gives good orientation to the dial. One can clearly differentiate the orientation of the dial where 12 o'clock is. So I like the fact the minute hand is larger than the hour hand. One can differentiate between the two arrow hands, and as you can see, it's outstanding loom performance. It's good to see Octopus Kraken haven't cut any corners with regards to the BGW9 Superluminova used. Now, another feature I really like about this watch, and I think again Octopus Kraken deserve full credit for, is the dial. It's made from ceramic, which is the same as the Omega Seamaster. It has the same style of wavy ceramic dial. To get laser cut ceramic wavy dial like this at this price point is unheard of, and usually dials at this price point would be metal and then painted, for example with enamel paint, but this is laser cut ceramic and the waves are just absolutely gorgeous the way they catch the light. They've also got the color tone correct between the ceramic bezel insert and the dial. They are the perfect blue tone match. Absolutely gorgeous. It's just incredible to get a ceramic dial at this price point. I'm finding it very impressive. So let's discuss the movement used in the piece, because again, it's another favorite aspect of the many favorite aspects of this piece. It uses the Calibre PT5000, which is made by HK Precision Technology in China. So the Calibre PT5000 came to global attention for positive reasons in 2018, when a Chinese brand used the Calibre PT5000 in a watch. They brought the watch to the Glashütte Observatory in Germany to have it chronometer certified. Now, usually movements are chronometer certified either by MITAS or by COSC. For example, Omega use MITAS and Rolex use COSC respectively. The problem is, because it's a Chinese made movement, it cannot be certified by MITAS or COSC. They only certify Swiss made chronometers. So the Chinese brand brought the watch and movements to the Glashütte Observatory because they will certify chronometer movements that are made outside of Switzerland. And they observed the movement and the PT5000 met chronometer grade accuracy. So cost chronometer grade accuracy is -4 to +6 seconds per day. Now, the stated accuracy of the PT5000 is ±12 seconds per day. So just to clarify, I'm not saying that every PT5000 is chronometer accurate. They're not regulated to chronometer accuracy every time by HK Precision Technology. But this one is very well regulated by Octopus Kraken, and it's consistently running at +2 seconds per day when it's fully wound to its maximum 40-hour power reserve. To get +2 seconds per day in a watch that only costs €291 is incredible. So the PT5000 is a clone of the ETA 2824-2. It has 25 joules, it runs at 28,800 vibrations per hour and a frequency of 4 Hz. 40-hour power reserve, which is perfectly acceptable, and it has hand winding and hacking, which I've demonstrated are useful complications. So it's an accurate movement, it's reliable, well proven, and a good solid workhorse movement. No negatives to it whatsoever. I really regard the PT5000 to be equal in quality to the ETA 2824-2, alternatively the SW200-1, which is made by Sellita. So lastly, I'll summarise the piece. What do I think of it overall? Well, when I'm considering reviewing a watch on my channel, the watch should meet two criteria. It should be both excellent quality and excellent value at the respective price point. So in the 11.11 AliExpress sale event, the price of this watch is going to be €291. So I'm going to base the price point on the sale price, €291. Yes, this is unquestionably excellent quality, and yes, it is unquestionably excellent value. It cannot be beaten for €291. I've previously reviewed other Seamaster homages by Pagani Design and also Ali's Dive, and I can tell you this is several levels above those pieces. The build quality, the quality control, the materials, and overall the finishing level of this watch is several levels above those watches. It's also loaded with specification. Laser cut wavy ceramic dial, fully loomed ceramic bezel insert with BGW9, Superluminova on the dial, hands, and also the ceramic bezel insert, 300 meters of water resistance, PT5000 movement, which is running at +2 seconds per day. There are no negatives to this watch whatsoever. Perfect bezel execution, perfect crown execution, perfect helium escape valve execution. This is a faultless watch. This is perfection personified. So I'm going to declare it a champagne watch for lemonade money. I'm going to highly recommend it to you for your consideration. I hope you've enjoyed my review of the Octopus Kraken Octopus Kraken. Please feel free to post your own comments below the video. Thank you very much.